So let's look at what I just said in more detail. What we said was, wouldn't it be nice if this term disappears? So let's take it away. Okay. So what we've said is we're going to pick our search directions to be a conjugate. This disappears. What now happens is that this part of what we have here is only dependent on y0. This part is only dependent on psi1. And therefore, minimizing the entire expression is the same as minimizing the first part over y0. And then minimizing the second part over psi1. Okay? And then you say, oh, wait a minute. But this really is just the same as minimizing over x over the span of all vectors except for the last one. So it is xk that minimizes this expression right here. And then this tells us how we need to add one more term to xk. This is xk. In order to come up with our next approximation for our solution. So now we can either say, look, we can actually use this expression to compute our psi1. Or you can recognize that this whole argument was all about how should we be picking our search directions. And if that is what it's all about, then all we do is say, okay, we're going to pick our search direction to be a conjugate. And then actually the algorithm simply continues with that. And then this alpha k is going to be exactly that psi1 that came up in this expression right here. And that turns out to actually be better because inherently round-off error will happen as the iteration proceeds. And as a result, it is actually better to use the most recent information about the residual as opposed to going back to the original right-hand side, B.